In this video, we are going to look at the guidance for the candidates sitting for the CS2 examinations in September 2020 term. Now, what we'll be doing in this video is that we'll be solving the September 2019 IFOA paper in the Word, and we'll see as to what all questions can be solved in Word and what all are the requirements, how to write different kinds of notations without the use of equation editor. So this PDF, which I am using currently, is being given by the IFOA last week, and they have talked about in this as to that there will be no change in the format of CS2B examination. It will be exactly in the similar fashion, but the CS2A paper will change a little bit. It is considered to be an open book examination where you will be having your own materials and IFOA material and your own PDFs and notes, whichever you have made. But what they have said over here, they have talked about the limitations of typing in Word, and so they have said that the question pattern may differ a little bit. By question pattern, we mean that there might be certain questions which will be straightforward from the book, which is knowledge based and which is exactly straightforward. So those questions will not be appearing, those questions will not be there in your September 2020 term. So they will, it is most likely that these types of questions will not appear in this term. Also, there will be some questions which will have a lot of algebraic expressions in it. So those questions may be modified into an MCQ, type of questions. Or the third possibility which is there is that these questions may appear, but then the marks will be increased. So three things. First of all, what they have said is that the question format of September 2020 CS2 exam may differ from the previous papers. Okay, so now we'll be discussing about the September 2019 term paper. So I would just suggest you all to open the question and the solution from September 2019. They have categorized all the questions into three categories. So the first category is the category which is likely to be excluded. This contains purely knowledge skill type questions, which is directly from the material, or questions which require graph, diagrams and charts. So these, and some questions which contain high degree of complex mathematical notation. So these three type of questions will be likely to be excluded from your September 2020 paper. Also, the two other categories are, the second one says that the likely to be included but with certain modification. Now, what the modification can be? The modification can be that the number of marks allotted may increase. So the number of marks may increase, as I said, because of the time taken in the Word will be obviously more. The scope of question is reduced. So maybe same sort of question will be appearing, but it might so happen the scope may reduce. They will give you the equations and they will ask you to find out the parameter values and so on. And also it can be converted into a MCQ type of a question. So these three possibilities are there where they can change the type or the format of the question. The third category is which require no such kind of mathematical notations and can be easily written in Word. So these type of questions will definitely appear in your 2020 term. So basically, you will find very few pure knowledge skill type questions. By this I mean the questions which will require exact testing of your knowledge as to what you have studied. Basically, this means that things which are appearing in your material, exact same things. It can be formulas, it can be definitions and so on. Then the paper will be divided into 75% of application based question and 25% of high order skills questions. So this mainly 25% HOD questions will require more of in-depth analysis of your CS2 knowledge, right? So moving on, we'll be solving the question paper. So the very first question is category 3, which is likely to be included without any modification. So I will show you all as to what the question is. So here I'll open the examiner's report. So this is my examiner's report, which you see over here. In this examiner's report, the very first question is this, and this question does not require any mathematical notations. As you can see, you can simply write this E total is equal to EA plus EB. This can be simply written in the paper. I'll show you all how to write this. Let me just do one thing. Let me just split the screen into two parts so that it is easier for me to make you all understand as to. So this is a very simple thing which you all can easily do in Word. Make sure your Word is very neat, or your presentation is very neat, and the examiner understands as to what you want to portray. Also, they have said that there is no need of using the equation editor at all. So do not use the equation editor, because they have said directly that there is no need to do so. This is equal to A plus, and see, this does not require any kind of notations, and you can just simply write 2.5 into. Now for multiplication, they have used this cross, which is basically this X they have used. Now it's up to you. You can use this X or you can use this star sign for multiplication, which they have said that can be done. So both the things are possible. You can again use this X. Simply see, I'm just showing you all, you can use the X or you all can use this star sign. Both are acceptable. Here, as we do not have any variables, here we have only numericals, 2.5, 1500, these are numericals. So we can go with X and we can simply write it in terms of X, not an issue. But where you have numerical, you have X as a numerical, in that case it becomes really difficult to understand whether you are typing a numerical or whether you are typing X, right? Or whether you mean multiplication or whether you mean the X variable. So in those cases, I would suggest to use this star symbol. So you can use this star symbol in those cases. Now similarly, you will write the variance. Instead of E, you can write V. So you'll get your answer. Now this 1500 to the power 2, what you can do is, let me just copy paste this entire thing once, and make sure you copy paste your answer a lot, because here you'll see a lot of repetitions. Use your arrow keys, use your control arrow keys a lot. So you have 2.5 into, we have 2 into, we have 1500 square. So now how you can write 1500 square? Again, you can give it in within brackets to the power 2. So you can do it to the power 2. That can also be done. Or what you can do over here, instead of this, what you could prefer doing is that you can use a subscript. Now how to use a subscript, how to use that, I'll show you all. See, this is 1250. What you can do, you can use two things. You can use a shortcut, or you can use in the home tab, in the font section, you will see something as superscript. So I'll just click on the superscript, and you see the cursor has moved up and you can write 2 over here. Again, click on the superscript to move back to the normal. Or you can use the shortcut, which is control shift equal to, and control shift plus or equal to will give you, see, will activate the superscript, and you can just simply type 2. For subscript, see, you'll type 2 again, control shift equal to, and you're back to the normal. Also for subscript, if suppose you want to write any subscript, let's say suppose you want to write SN, so you can write capital S, and then for subscript you can again select this button and write an N. Or what you could have done is use the shortcut, and the shortcut, see, it's control equal to. It's there within the brackets, control equal to. So control equal to will give you the subscript. Again, click on Control equal to move back to the normal. So Control equal to will give you subscript. Control Shift plus sign will give you superscript. You can use this or you can go without doing this, as you can write S underscore N. So all these three things are desirable and suitable for your examination. The second question again is entirely, as you can see, the first part is again whole a writing type of a question. You can just simply type everything down. Second part also is purely typed question, so you can easily type your answers down. Here you'll see what they have said, that part 1 and part 2 both fall into the category 3, means it will be included without any modifications and it requires no mathematical notations. So coming to question number 3, let me show you all the examiner's report. So in question number 3, we see that the first part is requires no mathematical notations. So they have kept it in category 3, which is it will be taken entirely without any modifications. Also, I will show you all how to write this in Word. So let me just split the screen into two. Here, what I would suggest you all in Word is that keep one answer in one page. So if this is answer number 1 in your first page, keep answer number 2 in your second page. Okay, so keep answer number 2 in second page and then keep answer number 3 in the third page, because just wherever, even if you finish your answer number 1 here, it is desirable that you go in a next page when you move on to the next answer. It looks really neat. So in question number 3, part 1, here we have a simple random walk. Now this can be written, this has discrete state space, or you can write it like this. Within the brackets, now you have 0 plus minus 1, so you can write it like this, plus minus 1. Or what you can do again is that you start with this and then you give minus 3, comma minus 2, comma minus 1, comma 0, 1, 2 and 3. So this also you can do, right? This is also exactly similar. Or you can write plus minus. For writing plus minus like this, we require the editor, so we'll go into the insert tab. In the symbols, in the equation section over here, let me show you all this. Let me delete this. We'll not use equation editor, but yes, in the insert section in the equations tab, you will get it over here. Just simply click on this and see, you will get your plus minus sign over here, right? So you can type in plus minus, but since we are not using equation editor at all, so we are not going to use this and we are going to delete this, because they have stated, the IFOE has mentioned that there is no need of using an equation editor. You can do all of the algebra, all of the writing with simple use of notations given by the IFOE. Okay, so this is it. You can do it, and then simply you can write discrete time domain. For part 2, as you can see over here, part 2, it contains a little bit of notations. You can simply write this plus 1 with probability p, minus 1 with probability 1 minus p. Also, p square can be written as p. I showed you all this. Two things can be done. You can simply write it as p square, or what you can do is you can give this superscript. So p, then superscript 2, or you can use an equation editor, as I showed you all, or you can use a shortcut, which is Control Shift plus and 2. Control Shift plus. So this is how you can write simply p square. Similarly, 1 minus p can also be written, 1 minus p, and then you give this caret symbol and 2. So this is a small p, or you could have used the subscript, superscript. Then we have, after this, we have So this is one way of representing. Now you will see that this will take more of a time than using the second approach or an alternative solution. But most, I believe that most of us will go with the first approach. This is what we generally learn. So most of us will generally go with the first approach. So what they will do is either they will increase the marks or they will limit it to time 1 and time 2. They will not take up to time 3. Or they may just increase the marks. So two possibilities, either they can limit the question for time 1 and time 2 and they can ignore the time 3, they cannot give time 3. Also they can increase the marks because it takes more time to type this down in Word rather than writing it in normal pen and paper. I'll show you all how to write this alternative solution which you see. This is exactly given in your notations by the IFOA. Now this is X. This is X. Now T can be written as underscore T, or what you could have done, you could have used the subscript. Both are manageable and both can be used by, as it is given by the IFOA, right? So this is equal to, now this is TCR, or this is a choose function which you do in R generally, and this is a combination basically. So what you can do, this is also stated in the notations given by the IFOA. I'll just show you all this. So in the notations they have given this binomial coefficient NCR as two things. You can either write N choose R, or you can write choose N comma R. This is exactly what you write in R programming, when you do R programming and you need to take out the combination, right? So multiply it by P to the power, again in bracket you can write T minus R, multiply it by, sorry, this has to be T, and this you can write 1 minus P to the power R. So this you can do exactly. This can be represented here, what you have seen. So let me do one thing, let me increase the font size. This you can do where R is equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on till T. Okay, this you can do easily. Now instead of this, if you do not prefer doing this, you can again keep it in within the brackets. Do not use X. So here instead of this you could have used X, but then it becomes really confusing, as here you have variables, you have T, you have R, so that X gets confusing because it can be assumed as a variable X, or it should be assumed as a multiplication. What they have said, let us see what they have said in their report. Category 2, so the part 2 question belongs to category 2, which will be included with slight modification. What is the modification which they will do? Is that increase the number of marks, as I said, or reduce the scope of questions to time 1 and 2 only, or convert it into a multiple choice question. So three things they can do easily, right? Moving on, I have showed you all, if not so, how you can write this function exactly in a similar fashion. You will write, if you want to give more brackets, if you think that the examiner will get confused with all of these, so you can give more brackets, not an issue. Two, three things you have to make sure is that give ample amount of spaces. As you can see, I've given space before the multiplication sign, after multiplication sign. I've given a lot of spaces in between. So make sure you're giving a lot of spaces, a lot of commas, a lot of brackets and all those. Also, here you'll see a lot of red marks because of the autocorrect feature of Word. You will see a lot of underlining blue and red marks. If you want to ignore this, you can simply go to the file options and you can untick the autocorrect feature from there. But I would not suggest that, because in that case also what happens is that whenever you make a spelling mistake, that also will not be taken into account. Instead, what you can do is simply right click on this and they will ask you some options, whether you want to add it to the dictionary or whether you want to ignore all. So you can do both. You can add it to the dictionary. If you add it to the dictionary, then when you next time open your Word file, any new word file and you type this again XT, you will not get any error. But when you do ignore all, then in the word, if you have used X underscore T anywhere, all of the lines will be removed. But even if you do not do this, it's fine because they will understand. Maybe they have turned off their autocorrect feature and they will not get these lines. But I would not suggest you to just switch it off, to turn off this autocorrect feature, because then if you have made any spelling mistakes, you will not be knowing. So the third part requires no mathematical notations. Third part is simply normal as n gets larger. So it requires no mathematical notations. Now coming on to the fourth question. Fourth question, part one, is likely to be excluded because it is a straightforward knowledge type question. So as it is an open book exam, so they will not give you any question which is knowledge based, which requires simple production of, or you can say simply you can produce it like what you learn and you can simply produce it over here. That will not be included in your exam. So here you can see this question is again talking about stationary distributions, and so you can filtration. So basically this is about straight away from your material. So this sort of question will simply be ignored. If not so, I will show you all how to write the very first thing. If not so, okay, if you want to learn this, you can learn this. I'll show you all how to type this down in Word. So the fourth answer, let me take it to the new page over here. So it's the first part. In this, I will show you all just this particular equation. So we have P, we have P XT, again XT can be written in this fashion, underscore T, and see, you do not get any red line because I chose ignore all for this document. Now this is belongs to or epsilon A. How you can get this? You can go to the insert tab in the symbols section. In the symbols section, see, already I have this epsilon, but how to get this in more symbols? In Greek and Coptic, in Greek and Coptic you will get this. Or what you can do, this is the small letter epsilon. You can either use this epsilon, which is a small letter epsilon, or you can use a capital epsilon also, which you'll also find it over here. See, capital letter epsilon, both I think you can use. So I can insert this as well, or if you want to insert this, you can insert this also. Once you insert it, it comes into the recently used symbols. What I would suggest you all is that keep your recently used symbols, most of the symbols which you use, or also you can avoid doing this. You can simply write epsilon or belongs to. Okay, so that also you can write as stated by the notations, like mu, sigma, all those. Instead of giving the symbol, you can write mu, mu, like that. So we have X. Then again we have S1. So for that, again you can give S1 like this, or you can use the subscript from here. Both are acceptable. Now this is again equal to X1. Okay, so I think that is simple. Again, in the similar fashion, you can write all other notations as well. I've showed you all how to get epsilon from the insert tab in the symbols section. You will find the epsilon. Both are usable, the capital epsilon or the small letter epsilon, both you can use. This is used generally for the error terms in your time series. This is generally used for the error terms, so I would suggest use this for error terms. You will find it in symbols in the Greek and Coptic section. Keep it in your recently used symbols handy so that you can use it whenever you want to. Here we have XT. Similarly, XT less than equal to. How to write less than equal to? Let me do one thing. Let me copy this bit. Just copy this bit and paste it over here. So here less than equal to can be written as less than sign equal to. This is also acceptable. as given by the IFOE notations, this is acceptable. IFOE has stated that you can use this particular less than equal to sign x given fs, given fs, and this is equal to your this entire probability, right? Similarly, you have ft, so I'll show you all this as well. We have ft bracket close, again you can write underscore p is greater than equal to 0, or you could have written this entirely in the subscript, so that can also be done. See, so that is fine. That is your fourth question, part one. Again, fourth question, part two is pure typing, so no mathematical equations. Now coming to part three, what they have stated here is part two is again okay. Part three, question part three, they say it's category two, likely to be included with certain modification. Now, what is the modification which they have stated? Is that the formula in the solution for matrix 3. So here we have three matrix, this is the first, this is the second, and this is matrix 3. In this case, in this matrix, when you want to write the matrix, see, this would not be suitable for the online delivery. However, candidates can use the notation set out in the IFOA, but their typing speed will, you will have to increase your typing speed. This part therefore could be modified by increasing the number of marks. So this is the first possibility, they can increase the marks, or they can only reduce the scope of the question to part 1 and part 2. So what they can do is reduce the scope to part 1 and part 2. They will not give you the third matrix which you see over here. They will not give you the third matrix, they will just keep it to the first two matrix. Also in the notations given by the IFOA, this is the notations which the IFOA gave, they haven't included anything about the matrix. They haven't included anything about the matrix over here as to how you can how you can write a matrix in Word. So I would assume you can write matrix simply in within the brackets, but then that will take a lot of time to do so. So what they'll do, they will just restrict it to the first two parts, or they can increase the marks. Only with a corresponding reduction in marks allocated, or by converting into a simple MCQ questions. Three things what they can do. Here I will show you all how to write this in Word, because although it might not so happen that this you will get in your examination, but you may get this. So let me just show you all. So this is question 4, part 3. And so here in part 3, I'm just going to show you all the first one. So here we have pi letter. How to get this? There are mainly two ways. First of all, in the insert, in the symbol section, I've already used pi once before, so it's there in my recently used symbols. When you go to the Greek and Coptic, in the Greek and Coptic itself, you will find the pi. You will just have to look for it a bit, and here you see you will find pi in Greek and Coptic, small letter pi, insert and close. So see, you get your pi over here. How to write 0 underscore 0, you can do this, or what you could do is simply just make it use subscript and write a 0. Both are acceptable, and then again 0.25 multiplied by pi. So again we have a pi. You can go to the insert symbols. Here we have already used pi, so it's there in my equation editor, and so I can just simply again write 0 like this, or I can use the subscript control plus, and I can write a 0 over here. Both can be done. Also, the second method of writing pi, I'll show you all, plus 0.5 plus 0.5 multiplied by, we have pi. So in the home tab, this is very interesting. In the home tab, convert, in the font section, convert the font into symbols. So just type FYM symbol, you get this symbol. Now whatever letter you type, that will be converted into the Greek symbol. Suppose I type P, so see, I get pi. You just have to type P and you get the pi. Let me do space. A will give you alpha, B will give you beta, G will give you gamma, R will give you rho, T will give you, U will give you mu, and so on. See, omega, theta, K. So these, each letter, for each letter, it will get converted into a simple Greek letter. So for pi, it is P. So when you write P, you get a pi. So this is also acceptable. You can do both the approach, but I would suggest to use this approach of going into the insert section in the symbols. Use it from the recently used symbols, because again and again changing the font will take a lot of time. You can do so, not an issue at all. Okay, so see, it gets converted back into P when I change it into the symbols. That's it. That is for your question number four, which you saw over here. I do not see anything new. You can simply make out, you can simply write this. Very simple. Moving on to the question number 5. Question number 5 is, again, you can see pure typing part 1. Likely to be included, but then this, if this is exactly from your material knowledge base, then that will not be included. See, it is likely to be excluded, the first part, because it is a straightforward knowledge type question. It is a straightforward knowledge type question. The train validation test approach uses 3 data sets. So basically this is directly from your material, not likely to be included because of the open book approach. Part 2 is a category 3 where it can be included without any modifications. So part 2, directly, it's an application based question, machine learning application based question, directly included. Similar case for part 3, machine learning direct application, you can simply use it without use of any word. So part 2 and part 3, typing, pure typing question, directly included. Part 1 again can be included, but it is a straightforward knowledge type question, so it might so happen that you will not get this question in September 2020. These kind of questions which are directly from your material. Okay, moving to question number 3. Now question number 3, let me open the question number 3. Question number 6, you can see, contains a bit of mathematical equations or algebra. How to type this, they have shown us how to type this. See, I will just show you all in the word. I will take this examiner's report and I will show how to type this in the word. Okay, so this is question number 6. So, answer 6, this is part 1, and here we have summation. So you can write sum over z, and then I'll just show you all how to write this entirely. So you can write zx in everything in brackets and then simply 2 to the power 2. What they have shown us, as you can see, it says c, sum over this entirely. So you need to write sum over x also, because obviously you can't skip, so I'll have to use one more bracket. See, now there are 3 ways of writing a sigma or a summation which they have given us in the notations. So this is the notations, this is the IFOA notations which they have given us for sigma. See, 3 things you can write. Sigma, here it's from A to B, lower limit, upper limit. So A comma B, lower limit, upper limit, colon, After colon, give whatever is there, give whatever is there in your within the sigma. See? Or instead of sigma, you can write sum. Or instead of this, you can write sum over A to B, and then within the brackets, you write your whatever is there within your summation. So three alternatives. They have used the third alternative. They have written sum over A to B, then within the brackets, whatever you want to write. Here it's only sum over x. So for all the values of x, basically sum over x, then within the brackets, you will write your equation. Z underscore x to the power 2. This is how you write. And then you can obviously write z underscore x is nothing but equal to. So how to write this? Very simple. B underscore x minus b underscore x. There is a e on top. Now remember, if you use, this is one mistake which I think most of us can make. If you write it like this, if you write this as this, you will get a zero, because this means dx to the power e, whereas this signifies your expected number of deaths. This is your actual deaths and this is your expected number of deaths. This e is just a notation over here. It is not to the power e. Here it was to the power 2, zx to the power 2, but here it is just a notation. So if you write this, use this caret symbol, you will get a 0. So in this case, what you will do is, you will give this within the bracket. So let me just ignore all. This should be within the brackets. This is how you write it. D underscore x, D underscore x e. Now this e, they will understand, is a superscript. Also, you could have used superscript and subscript simply, and you will get your answer. Square root of this entirely. So I will just copy paste this instead of typing it down again. So this is your zx, and that is the same thing which they have written over here in their solution. Zx, see, entirely in the similar fashion they have written. They have used the square root. This can be written as z square. This can be written as sum over x. Or what you could have done, if you would have used the first approach or the second approach, you could have written sum. Then within the bracket, simply x, give colon, and then write this thing over here. Copy and paste. Okay, copy and paste. This is the first approach. Or instead of sum, you could have written sigma. So sum over sigma or sum, giving colon, all are acceptable. You do not have any lower upper limit, you just mention x. So this is one of the ways of writing your summation. And now I will show you all, I will just tell you all how to do these calculations. These calculations will obviously have to be done in your table format. So what you will do is you will construct a table. You know that you will require 5 columns. So what I'll do over here in my Word is that I will construct a table. How to construct a table in Word? Go to the Insert tab. In the tables, just simply select. So I need 5 columns. I do not know how many rows I need, so I'll just select 3 for the time being. Let me see what are the different column headings over here which I require. Now the column headings is, first I need age, so I will write age. It got changed into symbols. So I'll write age, x, we have d underscore x, we have d underscore e, similarly I will just copy paste this instead of typing it again, and also what we have over here this is zx and this is z square. So what they have said also, what you should do, instead of typing it down this entirely, I can write over here, because I have written already what zx means, I can write z underscore x. Here I can write z square. Why should I type this entirely? Why should I type this again when I have written in my answer itself what the zx means? Right, because I have written over here what it means, there is no point of typing it on again. Here you can simply type down your age. When you move to this particular last cell, click on tab and you move to the next row. Click on tab, you move to the next cell, tab and you move to the next cell. You can simply click on tab and type, fill in all your columns. So it takes very less time. Instead of, so many people are asking me, can we write in Excel and just copy paste it here? Instead of Excel, I think this will be more easier, because you'll open Excel, you will type there, you will copy paste it in Word. Okay, so instead of that, here you just need to go to the insert tab, select the table, number of rows, columns you want, it will get inserted over here. You can decrease, increase if you want to, suppose delete a column. Select, click on backspace, it gets deleted. Select the entire row, click on backspace and it gets deleted. See, simply like you do in Excel. So no point in going in Excel, typing it there, copying and pasting it here. You can simply create a table here itself, right? So here you can simply write this in the form of table. Again, part 3 and part 2 require no other algebra. Here it requires this, we have already seen. So let us go to the report given by the IFOA. Part 2 is simply to be included without any modifications. Part 3, they say, is likely to be included again without any modifications. Now in part 3, we have to do certain tests. So these tests depend on you as to what kind of test you do. They have given solutions for everything. If you use cumulative deviations test, you will have to use these algebra. If you use grouping of signs test instead, if you use individual standardized deviation ISD test, these two tests will not require much of your notations, much of your algebra. So they suggest that you can write these two kinds of tests in Word, so that you do not have to type in a lot of notations, type in a lot of algebra. You can do a science test, but then that will not be conducive over here. You will not get your full marks, because they are not asking. So every sign, every test has its own significance. Grouping of signs and ISD test is done for clumping of signs, for checking clumping of signs, for testing whether there is clumping of signs or not. In the science test, you test it for some other purpose, so you will not get your full marks. But when you do these two tests, which will require less of mathematical notations, that is more desirable, instead of going with cumulative deviations test, which will require typing of certain algebraic notations. Okay, so this was question number 6. Again, here you will see this can be again written within your table. This can be again written within your table. See, they have themselves used notations over here. Zx minus z bar 1, z in the subscript you have x plus 1 minus z bar 2. So all this also, this is a serial correlations test. You can simply use this notations. I do not want to show this, because this is also simple notations. You now know how to insert table, and you can know how to increase columns, decrease columns, rows, delete and all those stuffs. So you can do it simply using this. You do not require any kind of further explanations on this. So we'll move on to the question number 7, which is partially changed in this notebook, which in this PDF which they have issued. Also, part 4 requires no mathematical typing. So part 4 is no mathematical notations, likely to be included without any modifications. Part 3 required a few of your tables which you can simply create in Word. Also, it is the choice of test which you perform which will decide the number of notations which you can use. So all these things you should keep in mind when you are doing things in Word. They will not I think go for such questions which will require a lot of typing of lot of mathematical notation. So that was it, question number 6. In our next class, we'll be discussing from question 7 onwards, where we'll see they have given us certain changes in question number 7. They have included certain MCQs as well. So that is it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed it. Thank you so much. We'll be continuing this in our next class.